Yes, sir! What's going on, everybody? It's your boy, Jay Easy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop, BK the People's Champ, coming to you live with another episode of the Mafia Story, man. This game's starting to get real good right now, man. And right now, I forgot even what episode. I think this was episode 7, it should be. Chapter 7. Yep, Chapter 7. And we just get out of jail in loving memory of Francesco Potenza, I guess.
Galante wasn't lying. He called in a few favors and arranged for me to get out early. Knocked almost 4 years off my sentence. Now, Joe used to come visit me and, you know, kind of fill me in on what was happening on the outside. But I tell you, as soon as I walked out of that prison gate, it was like a whole new world.
That's something that would have probably been like that for people that, let's say somebody went into jail in 19, like in like 90, I'm trying to think. Like if somebody went to jail in 93, right? And then got out in like 2001 or something. Man, that would have been crazy because they would have missed the whole internet. Y'all hold on 1 second, I gotta kill the program. I'm still here, but there's a, I gotta kill this program that's just eating up. It just eats up memory for whatever reason when you load up, cause I record using OBS. And this CF bootstrap crap, it just takes, I mean, I know what it is, it's the browser, but I don't need any alerts going on right now, you know what I'm saying? So you have to kill that about 3 times. All right, we back to it, man. Let's go. Hold on 1 second. I mean, y'all don't see anything different. Y'all just see my man standing still, but it makes a huge difference because, I mean, it makes my CPU go from like 90. Watch out a little bit. It makes my CPU go from like 90 to 50. Just closing out that little bootstrap joint, man. So if you're recording with OBS 64, it used to not even work in OBS 64. But what is this dude doing here? It used to not even work in OBS 64, which was lovely. So if I wanted to stream, I would stream with OBS 32. And then 64 didn't even have all that stuff, so 64 was like bare bones, but now they have the browser for OBS 64, so it is what it is.
Vito!
Hey, you break out of jail?
Ah, jeez, good to see you in regular clothes and on the right side of the bars again. Welcome home. Come on in.
Man, I tell you, lots changed since I went away.
Yeah, I guess it has. And hey, it ain't much, but I hooked you up with a nice little apartment, just like you
Thanks.
Said. Now I got a surprise for you. We're going out tonight to celebrate, and I'm going to introduce you to somebody.
Yeah, sounds good to me.
You're going
to
need a little cash so you can get things going again. I got a piece for you, too, if you want it. Ah, here. Always comes in handy. So, what do you want to do now that you're a free man?
Hey, what do you think? I want to go back to working with you again.
All right. I was worried they might have turned you straight
in
there.
I actually met a lot of people and learned a lot while I was on the inside. Got a much better idea of how things work now.
Good thing, because I wasn't exactly sitting around on my ass while you was in there. Don't worry, though. I'll show you the ropes, like always.
All right. Well, what are we waiting for? Let's go.
Jesus, I didn't expect you to be raring to go like this, but what the hell? Come on, let's go see your new place.
All right, we're going to go see my new place.
Go meet your new landlord. You do the driving so you can get back into the swing of things. Just hope you didn't forget how to drive while you was in the can.
Hey, what are you worried about?
It's
like riding a bicycle.
Sure, but when you smack up your bicycle, it don't cost a fortune to fix the friggin' thing.
That's right.
All right, I get it. You're like an old lady.
Yeah, I sure as hell hope so. And if you ain't noticed, cars are a lot different since you went away. You'll see. Your new place is just down the street, right near the boardwalk. You're gonna love it.
All right, cool. Well, let's go down to my new place. Where's my car anyway? Dude, where's my car yet again? But yeah, like I said, could you imagine having gone to jail in like 1993 or even let's say 95 or 98 and then you get out and it's 2001 or something like that. Let's say you do 8 years because like on, let's say on a dope charge, you do 8 years. So You get out in this 2001, right? And the internet and all that stuff has changed. It's just like Hard Eight used to say in his joint when he went in 99. When he came out in like 2010 or whatever, dog, it was not 2010, 2009, 2010. It was just like completely different. Like there was no Xbox. There wasn't no online gaming before that, you know, in 99, unless you was on computer or whatever. And then you come out and then you got the internet and everything.
Damn, like it's good to have you home.
That would be pretty crazy.
You was locked up, but now that you're out, the sky's the limit.
You see?
Damn right.
Nah, not for a few years now. You really felt bad about what happened, you know.
So what you been up to? We couldn't really talk about much when you visited me.
Well, after the shit Clemente and that little asshole Luca tried to pull on us, I got hooked up with the Falcone family and I started working for them.
Really?
Dang. Yeah, you'll see tonight. I told you, I got a nice surprise plan for you. But don't bother asking, because I ain't gonna tell you.
Oh. I feel you, though.
Don't worry. I've been planning this for weeks.
That's what I'm afraid of.
Don't tell me nothing.
Did you not see that light turn red?
Didn't care either. Yeah, this is why I turned the radio off right here, dog. Just for that issue, because like I said, I mean, I didn't get another notice or anything, so that was good. But like I said, though, man, it would just be insane for that to happen. Like you go somewhere, you go to jail, come back out. Or even if you went to war, like could you imagine when people went to the Vietnam War or even going to Iraq in 2001, and then like let's say if you were gone for a couple of years and then you come back and then like everything is different, like let's say you get deployed for a couple of years,
right,
3 years or something
enough.
Like that.
Park here.
Which
go check
I don't think
the place
anybody
out. It's on the top floor. I already paid the first month's rent for you. And hey, the entrance to your garage is on that side street over there.
Thanks, Joe.
I don't think anybody gets deployed for that long, but let's just say you did. Well, I don't know. I don't claim to know. I mean, my family never got deployed for that long. They only did like 1 year deployment, so however many months, like the short ones, but they're in the Navy, so.
Okay, here
always
we are.
Home, but,
I'm sure you'll find it to your liking. I live in a similar apartment myself.
Man, you can't afford
as
no
can
shit
see,
like this.
It even comes with a telephone at no extra charge.
Like my cousin, he got a.
Clean and modern, with all the hot water you could ever want.
Damn right. Like, he was deployed to Okinawa, Japan, and when he came back, I think he was over there a couple of years, 3 years, and then he came
and
back
here. Here is the master bedroom, and there is the master's bed. It's comfy, with room enough for two, maybe three. And it doesn't squeak. Always a plus in my book.
Damn right. Towel the ass up, you won't own it.
Sure hope you like your new apartment, sir.
If
you
Playboy.
Have any questions, feel free to ask.
I
just
will.
One question. When are you leaving?
Exactly.
Now, if you'll pardon me, I have to go and check on another client. Goodbye now.
Yes.
That was exactly what I was thinking. I'm about to turn no lights off. I just want to change. Okay, can I close the door? I can turn off the lights. Turn off the lights. But can I light a candle? But I ain't got no clothes, man. There we go. I was about to say, man, y'all got to stop with this. So is that suit darker? What I want, man? Let's just go with Hey, I'm feeling quite lavish today, man. I wanna be fresh to death. You talking about fresh to death? But yeah, like my cousin went to Okinawa, Japan, and came back. I mean, he said, you know, I mean that was only what three years. I think he was deployed. I can't tell you, but I mean, even then, I gave him a laptop when he went over there. Then obviously, I'm sure that they're. Technology was a lot further along, but when he came back, I know that laptop was completely obsolete. It just was. But yeah, it's all good though. But hey, but he had it when he went over there, and you know, I had to get him some plugs and all that stuff because I was selling computers and stuff back then. But oh well, you guys don't want to hear about all that. But yeah, I couldn't imagine being away for a long period of time, especially like a key period of time, which I suppose any period of time, get out of the way, is a key, uh-oh, yep, they saw that. I suppose any period of time is a key period of time, but, you know, if you're away, or like, let's say you'd have left in 2001 when cell phones were everybody had a Nokia 8190, and then you would have come out and everybody had, everybody's using flip phones, or you went in when everybody was using flip phones, and then when you came out, everybody's using tablets. Because they used to laugh at like the smartphones that we have now. I had one of the first ones. People used to just straight up laugh at me and be like, dog, you got a fucking brick. Why are you carrying that big ass shit around? Now everybody has phones like that. And then people used to say, How could you use a phone with no buttons and now somebody would laugh at you if you had a phone with buttons? It's just amazing how times change. Like, there was a time, like, when people look at the Teslas and, like, nobody's gonna drive a car that has autopilot. And I'm sure there was a time when people would not drive or use a plane that had autopilot, right? But now pilots don't even really fly anymore. They just use autopilot. Or you got, the one that me and Man always use is, we say, you know, I'm sure there was a time when nobody would get in a car. They would only ride horses. They wouldn't get in a car. And now you can't make somebody get on a horse. So, you know, it's just how times change and how things. So that's what I'm thinking. Like 20 years from now, man, people gonna be riding. People will be in Teslas, and most people ain't even gonna be using. Like old people like us will still be using the wheel and driving probably. But that young generation, they're just gonna adapt to it and just be like, shit, this is cool. I will never trust. And I'm saying that now, but who knows? I don't think I'll ever trust a car to drive itself, because it just doesn't know. It knows that some. Oh, Lord have mercy. Boy, I hope I don't get fucked up for that. Yeah. But it was in the game, so I think we okay. But yeah, like, now I lost my train of thought. Yeah, with that, I just think that people, you know, that's just how things change, man. Things change, and the more they change, the more they stay the same. And I just feel like a lot of people are going to adapt to that, but I just don't know if I will ever adapt to letting the car drive.
Jeez, I thought you was going to be a no-show. Not bad. Nice material.
Thanks. So, what's the plan for tonight?
You'll find out. A friend of mine's coming to pick us up. I met him when you was on your little vacation. And show him some respect. He's kind of an important guy.
Oh, yeah?
You'll see in a minute. Here he comes.
Hey, Joe.
Hey, Eddie. Here I am. How's it going?
Not too bad. Oh, this your buddy?
Yeah, this is my pal Vito. Vito. This here is a good friend of mine, Eddie Scarpa.
Nice to meet you, Eddie.
Same here, Vito. Okay, fellas, I'm dying for a drink. Let's go. Hey, Vito, you want to drive?
Damn right.
I had a couple of drinks already. So, you tell him where we're headed, Joey?
Nope. All he knows is that it's a surprise.
he's gonna love it.
I fucking hope so. Unless he got into the, funny business in the can.
Hell no.
What are you two talking about?
Don't worry about it. You'll see.
Hey, come on. We might as well tell him now.
Hey, you waited this long. We'll tell him in the car.
Exactly. I am fresh to death. But, I mean, I guess if you can show Grand Theft Auto titties and stuff, I mean, that shouldn't be a problem. If they hit me, right. I just have to take it
Let's
down.
Go,
I hope
Vito.
I don't get no strike.
Hey, you know,
there.
It would help if you told me where we're going.
Head to Oyster Bay.
This clearly says do not enter, and I'm just not even going to pay it any attention. That sign clearly says do not enter. But it's all right.
So, Vito, what was the one thing you missed the most when you was in the camp?
Freedom.
Yeah, well, but besides that?
Nah, you know, booze, broads, baseball, everything.
Now you're getting closer.
What, are you guys taking me to a baseball game?
No. We're taking you to the classiest cat house in the city, Vito.
Damn right. Nice, huh? Get some strokes.
Wow. Whoa, you don't sound too excited, Vito. Come on, don't tell me you don't want to have some fun after all that time.
Hey, don't worry, Vito. These girls are real professionals. If you forgot how to do it, they'll get you back in shape in no time.
Wow.
We're going to have a ball.
Damn right.
Remind me not to drink too much. There's something I got to take care of later.
What's more important than pussy and booze?
You know,
nothing.
Sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do.
Exactly.
Hey, Vito, come on, step on it, eh?
All right, I'm gonna step on it, but you know, somebody told me in the comments I couldn't drive worth shit, which I can't, but it's all good. Gonna see though, man. But like, I think that if it's the video game stuff, you don't have to worry about it. But
gonna see.
Run up when you see me, player. Hey, we gonna see. Red light. Sure did. And what? I'm rolling, 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 rolling. Keep rolling, rolling, rolling in this mother, mother. Rolling, 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 rolling. Keep rolling, rolling, rolling in this monkey facer. Dang, man, can we get there? I'll see you when you get there. If you ever get there, I'll see you when you get there. Might be a few things that I'm gonna have to edit out of this one, man. We gonna see though. See that truck right there gonna run up on
fucking city to come after us?
They were charging that much. They're gonna have to answer for their sins soon.
So I talked to Leo Galanti about you, Vito. He said you were a real stand-up guy, and he told me all about the shit that Clemente tried to pull on you guys. But between you and me, why'd you get into that line of work? I mean, we all got our reasons.
Well,
Yeah.
Because, you know, I don't want to end up like my old man, and,
Oh, no. Yeah.
Look, I figure nobody's gonna help me, so I gotta help myself.
You do. Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay, Scram baby. So, Vito, listen. I work for Carlo Falcone, and, we're looking to expand our operation. Joe's been working for us for a while now, and, since you're a friend of his, we'd like to extend that offer to you as well. What do you say?
Yeah, sure, I'm interested.
All right, let's drink to it. Here's to you guys.
All right.
And to a bright future together.
Touching down.
I can't be drinking too much tonight. I got some business to take care of.
Oh, dang.
Talk about a horse's ass!
No, really. Carlo's a real smart guy. He's into, astrology.
You mean astronomy?
Fuck you, you fucking cum dumpster.
Sorry, ladies. Looks like I gotta get going.
Shut your goddamn pie hole. If you wanna use your mouth.
You fellas ready to go?
Vito! Yeah, let's go. Hey, get up, Joe! I'm going home. Good night, you whores.
Shoot, that must have been the night show, cause they lit.
Hey, where the hell is my car? Somebody stole it. Hey, call the fucking cops, man.
You're staring at it, you lush.
Huh? Oh, yeah, good.
Y'all gonna get in?
Hey,
I mean, we ain't got all day.
Vito's gonna drive. He's the least fucked up out of all us.
Yes.
Yeah. Next time for us, Joe. More pussy, less booze. So, how'd you like the place, Vito?
A lot better than playing hide this each in the showers, huh?
Yeah, I ain't not interested in playing hide and go seek in the shower, player. Oof. Just not interested in that.
Eddie, you puke?
What? I wouldn't puke in my own car.
Exactly.
What the hell is that smell then?
Oh, yeah, I'm smelling it too.
Sulfur.
Must be Frankenpots.
What? That asshole puked in your car?
Nah, he's in a trunk.
What?
The fuck?
Hey, it's all your fault, Joey. I told you I had some fucking business to take care of, and you went and got me drunk.
Hey, since when does business to take care of mean dead guy in the trunk?
Exactly.
Hey, whoa, whoa, whoa. Hey, calm down, Vito. Hey, I spätte. We'll figure something out.
What's to figure? All we gotta do is bury the stiff. I already got his spot picked out, up by the old observatory.
Let's get it, man.
You got a shovel?
Sure, it's in the trunk. And the hole is already dug. All we need to do is chuck him in and cover him up.
All right, where's this hole?
A little ways outside of town, there's a path in the forest to a small clearing. That's where the hole is.
Let's roll then.
And hurry it up, will ya? God, I need some fresh air.
Let's the roll then.
This is fucking killing me.
I know, you need some fresh air because your ass is drunk. Not for nothing else. Man, we about to Esther roll a lot, though. Okay, let me stop, because you can't tell what's coming up here. All right.
Oh, stop. Now, I'm gonna hurl.
Get your ass up. Yo, he really is throwing up. For real, for real. Damn. Oh, shit.
Jesus, where's this shit coming from?
Yo, he is puking shit. For real.
Whoa, I don't remember eating calamari.
Get your ass back in the car, dog.
Can't hold your booze, can you?
I wonder, could I have made him throw up in the car? Or if I would have failed a mission if I would have let him throw up in the car? I don't know, who knows? Let's just get to this hole and get this over with. One of the simpler missions in this game. You're damn right. You're damn right. And twiddly diddly diddly. Yeah, yeah. You're damn right. And twiddly diddly diddly. Yeah, yeah. Hit that young ass. Slow down. Gotta cool it down, man.
Cool it down. You gotta slow it down. Ooh, watch out. You're gonna lose control in this motherfucker.
Can I pass this dude? Does this car even go that fast? It may not. Yeah, we got him. Only because he's too scared to drive around the mountains, right? She'll be coming round the mountain when she come. She'll be coming round the mountain when she come. She'll be coming round the mountain. She'll be coming round the mountain. She'll be coming round the mountain when she come. Hi. As we continue, as we proceed, I'm not stopping to give y'all what y'all need. This ain't like that game Driver, man, where you have to obey the laws, you know what I'm saying? Like, you can just do what the hell you want to. That's what I'm about to do. Yes! You better go, best friend. That's my best friend. That's my best friend.
Come on, Lee! Come on!
Yep, blowing right through stop signs is what I do, shout. Hopefully they don't mess with me. If you really want to party with me, let me see this, what you got for me. Put all your hands where my eyes can see. Straight buck wildin' in the place to be. If you really wanna party with me, in God we trust. Just slide off through here. Yeah, so I was looking at the wrong thing every time I was driving. Are they really checking to see what kind of damage the car has when we really don't even care? Dog, we don't care. Like, nobody cares about your busted-ass car. Alright? And it seems like the police are following us for some reason, both odd and unknown, but I don't care. So, just so you know, I was always looking at the red needle. Okay. Am I supposed to just run through that? Fuck it then. How am I supposed to get through here? Fuck that gate. That was probably a more
diplomatic way that I could have done that, but yeah, I don't know, man.
All right, we're here.
Vito, go pop the trunk.
Is that a joke? That's great. That's just great. Yeah.
God damn it, new shoes. Jesus Christ.
Oh, fucking Christ almighty. How long this guy been in here, Ready?
Just a couple days.
You're gonna have to get him out of there, Vito.
That's just great.
I can't handle the smell.
Some fucking welcome home this is.
Oh.
Boo!
Hey, mother. Hey, here's a hole. Right here. Dump him in.
Finally, done. Okay, now who's gonna bury him?
What?
Give me a minute to get a hold of myself. Can you just do it? Every time I get a whiff of the guy, makes me have to puke. And Eddie's not gonna be any help here.
Fine, whatever.
Hey, fellas. How about a little music, eh?
You gotta be kidding me.
Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go.
This wasn't supposed to be part of your homecoming party, but it's nice out here, ain't it? Well, I ain't been in the woods for a while.
Yeah, you won't be liking it so damn much after I smack you with this shovel.
So I really had to do all that by myself, but it is what it is. At least they didn't make me, bury him like I didn't have to shovel it like they were doing, like they were going to try to make me carry those crates. That one thing, I wonder if you get an achievement if you fill that thing up and carry all the crates. Hey, let's see what's going on down here. Why not? Because we're in the woods and it looks like somewhere that Bloody Freddy would frequent.
You guys kidding me with this? Oh my god, what do you know?
I know, right? I don't get it, but hey, it is what it is. Man, can't turn it off? I'm trying to overshadow the music, man, because I don't want to hear that. Yep. They put those gates back quite quickly, didn't they? But it's all good. They do quick work. We do even faster work. Like, can we turn that off? I'm gonna go with safe driving. My darling. That way I don't have to worry about nothing. Like, I really don't want to hear that. Yo, I'm not trying to hear that. Turn that damn music off! Like, it's just on there. I can't turn it off. I do have on the speed limiter, so I'm good. But, you know, hopefully they don't screw me over with this music and be like it's on, like it was music and then they claim the video or whatever. Which, I mean, I guess I really wouldn't care too much because I ain't like I'm making nothing off of it anyway. But, you know, it just is what it is. Exactly. You don't know the words. Shut the fuck up! Up! Oh my god. Stop it. Stop it. Spare me, please. I'm gonna try to go down this hill without. Oh!
Yeah.
Yep, that didn't work out how I thought it would. Thought I could go down the hill without breaking. Trying some new shit. Yeah! What I should have done is broken then accelerated through the corner. Something like this. There you go. You accelerate through the corner and then you don't have nothing to worry about. But nope. Nope. See, come off the gas and then accelerate through that corner. Ooh, I'm I gonna make it though? That's the... Boy, in that cab, boy, you lucky. You lucky I got anti-lock brakes on here. Yes! Let us continue. Like I said, I don't think they bother you for video game nudity, man, but I just don't even want to take no chance. I just had to edit that part out. I'm sorry. I picked up a magazine off the ground and it was just like, what? Titties? The fuck? So, fuck that. I don't know, man. Who knows? We in here.
Sorry, Vito. Not exactly the best way to end the night, huh? But thanks. I owe you one big time. Leave Eddie's car here so he can get home in the morning.
You're a good man, Vito. I'll settle up with you tomorrow. Hey, you coming in for some drinks?
It's 3 a.m. Shut the hell up!
Hey, shut up, you whore!
Come on!
You had enough, Eddie. Girls. You're going to bed. Come on. I'll call you tomorrow, Vito. Good night.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, that seems like that's the end of that one. Chapter 7. So we're going to keep on going on, and tomorrow we'll have up Chapter 8, man. Hope you guys enjoying the playthrough as it stands. And, yo, it's getting good, man. So, you know, we're just going to keep on rolling. But I'm out of here. Till next time. It's your boy, Jay Easy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop, BK the People's Champ. Holla! 360 out this month.